What is that? When you think liver disease, what comes to mind first? Liver disease and cirrhosis due to alcohol abuse? Or liver disease due to processed foods that we're eating? If you guess that it is the food that we're eating, you are correct. There are two types of fatty liver disease. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease has become the most common chronic liver condition worldwide, affecting up to 30% of the adult population. Alcohol fatty liver disease, in contrast, is considered less, statistics showing less than 5% of the population suffering from this disease. So let's learn about non-alcoholic fatty liver disease condition, or let's just say NAFLD, a condition that can require a liver transplant. In fact, there are distinctly more liver transplants given to people with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease that's secondary to processed food than those suffering from alcoholism. So what is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease? Basically, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is characterized by the buildup of excess fat in the liver of people who drink little to no alcohol. The liver normally contains some fat, but if it is more than 5% of the liver's weight, then it is called a fatty liver. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease can be simple fatty liver where fat accumulates in the liver cells, but there's no inflammation or liver cell damage beyond that. This type doesn't usually progress or cause liver damage. But there's another condition that's called NASH, non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. This is where fat buildup and inflammation and liver damage occur. This is the type that leads to fibrosis and cirrhosis, which means severe scarring, and even liver cancer. About 20% of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease can develop severe type, which will require transplantation or die of a fatal liver-related disease. So non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is a pretty serious condition. So how do you get fatty liver? A fatty liver often exists alongside obesity and metabolic syndrome. What does metabolic syndrome mean? Diabetes, high blood pressure. These can all be caused by a variety of factors such as genetics, insufficient exercise, stress, a disturbed gut microbiome. But the major driver by far is the processed food that we eat. There's mounting evidence suggesting that increased consumption of ultra-processed foods is the key driver of metabolic syndrome in general, and of interest to us in this video, fatty liver disease. So basically, it's alcohol or processed food are the key drivers. But let's just clarify, what do I mean by ultra-processed foods? According to the Brazilian food classification system, NOVA, ultra-processed foods are defined as industrial formulations made mostly or entirely from substances derived from foods and additives with little, if any, intact whole foods. Examples include soft drinks, sweet and savory snacks, reconstituted meat products, prepared frozen dishes, and more. Basically, ultra-processed foods. These highly palatable and convenient products now make up at least 50% of the total dietary energy consumed in high-income countries like Canada, US, the UK. In some parts of the country where food deserts exist, it can be as much as 100% of the food that's available. How does ultra-processed food actually create fatty liver? We can understand how alcohol can affect the liver over time. Basically, the alcohol are creating a toxin to the liver. How can foods do that? Here are some ways. One way, the high sugar and refined carbohydrate load leads to insulin resistance. In other words, diabetes, which then contributes to fatty liver. Second way, food additives like emulsifiers and artificial sweeteners can alter gut microbiota and increase intestinal permeability, allowing bacterial endotoxins to reach the liver. What we call leaky gut syndrome can cause damage to the liver. Third, lack of fiber and micronutrients can impair gut barrier function and antioxidant defenses in the liver. And finally, acellular nutrients, basically ingredients like gelatin, grains, seeds, are rapidly absorbed and they can overwhelm the liver. And we have research to show strong associations between ultra-processed food and the risk of fatty liver disease. A recent systematic review and meta-analysis of 9 studies involving 60,000 individuals concluded that high consumers of ultra-processed foods had 42% increased risk of fatty liver disease compared to lower consumers. Fatty liver disease is known as a silent killer. And once fatty liver syndrome starts, it's silent and over years or decades ultimately leads to cirrhosis. It can an average of about 20 years to go from fatty liver to cirrhosis. So what do we do? Is it too late? Is it ever too late? It's not a surprise to know in terms of what to do that avoiding processed food high in added sugars in favor of a minimally processed whole food is much better. So things like the Mediterranean diet or the low carb or the keto diet are very helpful. Basically, just avoiding the processed food component in your diet makes a big difference. So specifically, limiting the ultra-processed snacks, desserts, and fast foods. 2, avoiding sugar-sweetened beverages and refined grain. 3, increasing intake of fiber-rich whole grains, fruits, vegetables, legumes, nuts, seeds. 4, increasing healthy fats from olive oil, avocados, and omega-3-rich fish. And 5, moderating portions of red meat and consuming as many proteins as possible, especially in the unprocessed variety. The good news is that once the individual has changed their diet, the liver will recover. The liver is remarkably regenerative, and providing not too much scarring or damage has occurred, the liver can recover. You can expect to halt or even reverse the progression of the disease if you catch it in time. Recovery is possible in the same way as people can reverse their diabetes and their mood disorders. Together, we can strive to minimize ultra-processed foods in our diets and advocate for policies that make healthy, minimally processed foods more affordable and accessible to all. Basically, shifting away from ultra-processed foods and towards a whole food meal plan is a key strategy for turning around the tide of the non-alcoholic fatty liver epidemic. Now, if you're finding it difficult to stop eating processed foods, knowing what you know now, please see my other videos on ultra-processed food addiction. There's a reason why it's hard to stop, and I hope I've given you a good reason why you would want to stop, aside from just not wanting to live in the hell of food addiction. If you want to know more about cirrhosis, the end stage of fatty liver disease, then check out this video. Thank you.